Hi, welcome back to social science class. This is your Naveen. In previous class, we were talking about the Karnataka climate and soils of Karnataka. Under that, we have studied the four types of soil. First, red soil, block, laterite, and coastal alluvial soil. In today's class, we are going to learn more on the types of vegetation. Under that, Karnataka is called as a land of sandalwood. Why? We will see the answers for that. Before going to that, the various kinds of plants and trees are growing naturally are referred as a natural vegetation. Karnataka has rich diversity of plant species. The plant species play an important role in preserving the ecological balance. The trees provide timber, firewood, raw material for industries, medical herbs, honey, bamboo, cane, etc. The forest being a habitat for wild animals, we can see tiger, lion, cheetahs, wild buffaloes, elephants, deer, and peacocks in the forest of Karnataka. These forests are also a place of entertainment and tourism. They help to control environment pollution also. So, sandalwood is a special tree grown in forest of Karnataka, which uses for perfume. Object is the intricate carving, soap, and medicines are manufactured from sandalwood. Sandalwood are popular all over the world and hence are not only supplied to other parts of the country but also exported to foreign countries. That is the reason Karnataka is called as land of sandalwood. Types of vegetation we can come here, that is a natural vegetation of Karnataka, broadly classified into the on the basis of rain, relief feature and type of soils. We can classify into evergreen forest, deciduous forest, mixed forest and grassland and shrubs. We can go for the first one, evergreen forest. See, in the evergreen forest, where we can look at it, the area which is having rainfall more than 250 centimeters annually, that area is having contained with the evergreen forest. So, on account of heavy rain and high temperature, the trees grow tall and dense in here. These forests being dense are impenetrable. The sunlight does not reach ground at all. Different types of tall trees like rosewood, mahogany, kino, teak, dupa, and hebbalasu grow in this forest. Or at the base of these trees are thick shrubs. Different types of spices we can see. That is spices like cinnamon, cardamom, cloves and medical herbs grow in abundance. This kind of forest can be seen in parts of Uttara Kannada, Dakshina Kannada, Shivamogga, Hasan, Chikkamagaluru, Chamarajanagar and Kodagu districts. The second part is second types of forest is deciduous forest. After winter, due to lack of moisture in the soil and trees, trees shed their leaves. The leaves reappear during spring seasons, right? What are the forest which shed their leaves after winter? That is, we are calling as a deciduous forest. This kind of forest can be seen areas which is having the rainfall of 60 to 100 centimeters annually. The districts like Chikkamagaluru, Mysuru, Chamarajanagar, eastern part of Hasan, Tumkuru, Chikkaballapur, southern part of Kola, Mandya, Ramanagar and Bengaluru rural districts. And teak, kino, mahogany, neem, mango, jack, flake, cocoa, banyan tree, sandal and bamboo grows in plenty. So these forests are not dense. So next, coming to the next verb, that is mixed forest. This, the growing of evergreen and deciduous together, that is we are calling by the name of mixed forest. The annual rainfall here is 120 centimeters to the 150 centimeters. Examples, districts like Udupi, some part of Uttara Kannada, Dakshina Kannada, eastern part of Kodagu, Chikkamagaluru, Hasan, Mysore districts, we can see mixed forest. Important trees, teak, kino, mahogany, axal, sandal, jack and bamboo grows in abundance. And these trees have commercial value, that is important here. And grasslands, areas receiving the less than the, what are the 60 centimeters of rainfall, which have the thick, have this kind of vegetation. Due to low rainfall or the scanty rain and dry weather, there is a short grass, thorny shrubs and shrubs vegetation. Example, cactus, acacia, babul, bela, palm trees, hunchi, kunti grass, etc. Occasionally, banyan, neem, peepal tree, palas trees grow here and there. This type of vegetation we can see in Bidar, Kalaburgi, Yadagiri, Raichur, Koppal, Vijaipur, Ballari, Chitradurga, and other areas. Deltas, exclusively, and beaches, is coastal areas have the peculiar types of vegetation that has aerial roots and can grow in salty water. These are called mangrove forest. Which are the What is the mangrove forest? Which trees are grown in the salty water? That is, we can call as a mangrove forest. Areas which are more than 1,400 meters above sea level have cool climate. Example, Kudremukh, Babu Budangiri, Biligiri Ramangana Betta, and Brahmagiri in Kodagu are the few places. They have grassy slopes, the valley with the streams, rills, etc. What are the distincts were there? That is, we are calling by the name of Shola forest. What are the distribution of forest in Karnataka? The recorded forest area of Karnataka state is 443.4 lakh square kilometers. This is form 22.6% of the total geographical area. Karnataka occupies the seventh place in forest resources in the country. Uttara Kannada district has minimum forest area. Next to it are Shivamogga and Chamarajanagara district. Vijayapura district have the least forest area. This is about our forest. In the upcoming class, we are going to talk about the animal resources. Thank you for watching video. Stay tuned to GJS. Have a great day ahead.